Yeah, we could have predicted that the moment a new FPS game launches, the words COD and killer would be echoed throughout the internet. I have made a video on XDefiant. Hell, I've streamed it ages ago. But if I were to summarize it, it's a fine shooter, a decent game that I haven't personally gotten super into, but I see its appeal. Now, coming back to the topic of this video, is this game a COD killer? Well, I have two things to say about that. First of all, I'm convinced that Activision could pump out shit of poopy modern diarrhea, and people would god defend that game until the end of time. The franchise seems almost unkillable because of the extremely dedicated fanbase it has collected, so at this point it's hard to take anyone seriously when they say that the new fast-paced FPS game is a COD killer. I mean, has there ever been a COD killer? Second of all, and this one is more subjective, I personally divide FPS games into three categories. The top ones are the big names everyone knows, like Call of Duty, Battlefield, Counter-Strike, etc. Even if you haven't played these games, you know about them because they are more mainstream and just more popular in general, possibly because of the years and years these games have been around for. The bottom ones are the lesser known, more niche titles that I'm sure at least one of you would recognize because you were looking for a free first person shooter to try out, maybe from a YouTube video showing the top whatever free shooters on Steam. That would be games like Warface, Iron Sight, Dirty Bomb, and so on. Now, just because I consider these games to be at the quote unquote bottom, doesn't mean that they are literally bottom of the barrel. These are games that are less known, less populated, but they can still give you a good time. Now the middle. Games that are more known than the bottom. Maybe you've seen a YouTuber recommend them or be sponsored by them. Still somewhat niche, but more people have heard of them. That's where I would put Insurgency Sandstorm, World War 3, maybe even Enlisted, and definitely XDefiant. I feel like if Ubisoft's only decent game as of late finds its identity, it can climb higher, but for the time being, you can't really describe XDefiant without talking about Call of Duty. Hell, maybe it is what Black Ops 4 tried to be with the specialist and the longer time to kill. But if it wants to genuinely compete with the monolith that is COD, it has to be more. I've noticed that because of the devolving quality of FPS games from the past few years, we have lowered our standards and the bar is quite low right now. I mean, the moment XDefiant has announced no SBMM, everyone started cheering like it's the second coming of Christ. Don't get me wrong, I'm also happy about this. I was sick of the weird matchmaking, whether it was SBMM, or EOMM, or SMDMM. It's great, fantastic. I stopped playing the newer COD titles because that shit was annoying. But that sort of seems like the bare fucking minimum, doesn't it? It's like celebrating that an FPS game has working hit detection. My point is, no. XDefiant is not a COD killer, but it does have potential to be a great shooter you can play it alongside COD if that's what you like. The games can coexist and they don't have to go to war with each other. Why does everything have to be black and white? It's not kill or be killed, or at least it shouldn't be. I'm rooting for both games. I hope COD gets their collective shit together and stops giving me more reasons to ignore their new titles. Hell, maybe they'll even give me reasons to actually want to try them out. And I'm rooting for XDefiant to try a little harder, try to stand out from the crowd by doing its own thing and to not antagonize Call of Duty. Remember when Battlefield did a World War 1 game? Even though that's a less popular topic than World War 2 or modern military stuff, well, that's exactly why that game separated itself from the generic junk that was coming out at the time. Perhaps that's what XDefiant needs. Either way, those are my two cents on the matter. Let me know what you think. Do you agree, or have I spent the last few minutes spewing a concerning amount of shit out of my mouth? Comment below. Huge thank you for watching. I hope this video gave you a new perspective on the topic. Like it, dislike it, subscribe, report for misinformation, all the good stuff, and I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.